Now, we've seen that it is very common in surgical practice to see a diabetic patient, but why is it so important to identify them? Well, many of them will have comorbid complications through vascular effects. They have microvascular problems that affects their brains, their coronaries with cardiac problems, and especially their kidneys, not to mention their peripheries. They also suffer from fluid shifts. They have a osmotic diuresis with the glucose. They also have electrolyte shifts. If you give a patient insulin with glucose, you will shift their potassium intracellularly. So it's very important. Risks for hypoglycemia. If they get too much insulin or not enough glucose, they might suffer perioperative bouts of hypoglycemia. Also hyperglycemia if their control is not tight, with acidosis, shock, etc. These patients have immune deficits. They have polymorphonuclear cell abnormalities. They don't attract these cells appropriately to areas where they are needed. They have phagocytic problems as well. And that will definitely lead to a higher incidence of postoperative septic complications, wound sepsis, etc. They have poorer healing rates, for instance, and that might be important when you do anastomosis. They definitely overall have a higher rate of morbidity and mortality. So how do we diagnose these patients? Well, first of all, there'll be the subset that come in and tell you, I have diabetes. It's important to find out what type they have, how long they've had it, what medication they're on, and what comorbid problems they do suffer from. Some won't know that they have diabetes or at risk of developing diabetes. And for these, you really have to take a careful history and a physical examination, as you do with all patients. Some institutions, as patients come in for the first time, for first consultation, they might get your analysis and you might pick that up on the dipsticks. It's important to listen out for the following things: that polyuria, that's where they urinate a lot, polydipsia, where they're thirsty all the time and want to drink a lot, and weight loss. These might be indicative of type 1 diabetes. And always be careful, of course, with overweight patients. They are at high risk for suffering type 2 diabetes. There are general known risk factors such as age, sex, family history, and problems with exercise levels. And these have even been built into an online calculator, as we had with the cardiac situation. And you can see it there. It's bit.ly/, that's a 1, a lowercase 0, an uppercase JZ, a 0, a G, and an uppercase I. And you can see an online calculator that you can use. Watch out for the patient who comes for vascular surgery. Up to 20% of them will be diabetics. Watch out for the patients on high-dose corticosteroids. Up to 50% of them will have post-operative bouts of abnormal glucose levels. Now, once these patients are suspected of being diabetic, you can send them for fasting glucose levels. If there's any abnormality, they can have a proper glucose tolerance test. It is not recommended to send diabetics for HbA1c levels. They're going to give you some estimate as to how good their control has been, but it's not really going to alter your surgical management of these patients. Now, once a diabetic has been diagnosed, or you see a patient coming for surgery who is a diabetic, there's a suggestion that this is your chance to examine at least their hearts and their kidneys. So it's not always feasible, but consider sending these patients at least for stress ECG, to look at their coronaries and to do renal function tests on them. We want to know their blood urea nitrogen, or the urea and creatinine, and especially their electrolytes.